morning. I'm Jeff Stier. I am director of the Risk Analysis Division of the National Center for Public Policy Research, a company shareholder. Thank you for taking my question. I'm asking about one in particular, the many ways government is increasingly involved in the delivery of health care, specifically a program called academic detailing. And academic detailing, as you know, the federal government, through a new agency for health care research and quality arising from President Obama's 2009 stimulus, has been dispersing millions of dollars in taxpayer funds to public relations agencies who send representatives called academic detailers to doctors' offices to advise doctors as to what drugs they should prescribe and for what purposes. This is somewhat like when firms like ours send drug detailers to speak with doctors about our products, with a very major difference. Our company is strictly regulated by the FDA in terms of what we can and cannot say. The federal government is not only not regulated, but it refuses to be transparent about the advice its academic detailers are giving. Yet the government has a huge conflict of interest in that it wants health care costs to be kept as low as possible. Look, we all want to keep health care costs as low as possible, but many classes of drugs, among them statins, antihypertensives, analgesics, antipsychotic medicines, the selection of the appropriate drug among many possibilities requires a delicate balancing of the effectiveness and acceptable side effects in each unique patient. Are government-funded detailers taking such phenomena into account? Do they explain these nuances to doctors? Look, we just don't know. What we do know is that the initial academic detailing grants are intended to disseminate the findings of comparative effectiveness research, which evaluates treatment outcomes derived from large populations as opposed to patient-specific data. This approach can be harmful to patients who don't respond to medicine in the same way as majority of patients. So my question to you is, what is Pfizer's position on this matter? And if you agree with us that the government's lack of transparency is potentially dangerous to American patients, to what extent do you expect the pharmaceutical industry, Pfizer in particular, to urge Congress to defund this academic detailing program, or at the very least, to require it to demand transparency so the American people will know exactly what the government is doing here? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. Thank you. I'd like to say you expressed it very eloquently. Our views are 100% coincide with yours. We think it's a waste of public money. And certainly we disagree with the fact that the government-funded academic detailers are not bound by the same rules of detailing and the same rules of truthfulness that we are. We have, as both part of the Pharmaceutical Manufacturers Association and Pfizer's individual efforts, we continue to educate Congress on this issue and work with allies to try and get a reform on this issue. But as you know, it's a really large law, and a lot of things are integrated into that law, and there are a lot of things that need to be reformed in that law, and this is just one of them. So thank you for your question.